About 2 months back, I was browsing digikey, and I came across this strange solder paste. It's strange because it says low temp. I looked down below, and it is, in fact, ROHS. It's actually got tin and bismuth, of all things. And it's pretty cheap, so I figured I would go buy some, and after all, with a data sheet like this, new product, this thing is liquidous. Well, you know, where could I go wrong? So I bought some, right here. And it comes in these nice little 5mm syringes. It comes with a little syringe head, which I tried, didn't really pan out for me. So I'm gonna go and use the old technique of good old trusty toothpick and board, and I'm just gonna show you guys just how awesome this stuff is. Ordinarily, when dealing with solder paste, you have to have fairly tight temperature controls in order to make the solder paste melt and not cause damage to your parts, especially temperature-sensitive parts. Not true with this stuff. Generally, as long as you get it hot enough to melt, you're probably not going to toast your board. At home, I use a toaster oven, and I just kind of watch it and wait for it to melt, and with this stuff, I have yet to toast any parts. I don't even have a PID controller or anything. Unfortunately, right now I'm at Unity Studios, so I don't really get that luxury. So I found in the halogen bulb from Harbor Freight, and just put a little piece of sheet metal on top, and this is going to be my my reflow station for today. And because this is going to be some very bright light, definitely borrow some sunglasses, even if you have to borrow them from some dude's girlfriend. So I'm just going to take this board and place it on this light. Try not to knock the parts around too much. And I'm turning down the exposure just so you can kind of see what's going on. Let's see here. Let's just give it a moment, and it's going to slowly melt the solder paste. It's been a very small amount of time, and it's already melted basically the entire board. Just wanted to show you guys how easy it is to fix solder bridges with this, so I'm just going to go in right here, doing it one-handed, looking through the camera. Just pull it out. Blammo, solder bridge is gone. Wasn't that easy. And now, we play the game, Does It Program? maybe I have the programming header in backwards. Okay, let's try that. Indeed, it programs. And, as that light is just barely on, it means everything is A-OK.